Hello and welcome to session 11 in this online course taking you through George Spencer Brown's wonderful work, Laws of Form. In this session, we're going to be looking at extending some of the consequences we've been working on previously. First, we start with J2. Now, you know we've been chanting things like A mark B mark mark over 2 R equals A R mark over 2, B R mark over 2, mark over 2. Notice we've changed the terms here. Instead of P and Q, we've got A, B, because we could go on indefinitely. A, B, C, D. And don't worry, I'm not going to chant the whole thing for you. You can do that on your own. So, how do we know that this can be extended indefinitely? Well, let's do this methodically. Let's consider cases in which a space is divided into 0, 1, 2, and more than 2 subsections. First of all, when it's divided into no subsections, well, we have an empty mark. And we know that by C3, anything next to an empty mark can be got rid of. So that solves that case. If there's one division, then we're left with mark over mark. That gets cancelled. And whatever's inside gets moved to the outside. Outside is inside. They are one and the same in form, in this case. Now, if there are two subdivisions of a space, then it's our old friend J2. If there are more than two, then what we can do is apply a sequence we've met before, C1, J2, C1, and this is how it works. What we're doing is creating dual divisions at every level that we can move the outside term into and copy it in to the two levels. Now, we always move the outside term two levels to the left. Here's how it happens for the first move. Be careful where you move the outside term because there are quite a few lines and it's important to get it into the right space. The next move takes the inside term and moves it across so that you end up with two sets of nested marks that can be removed, and you'll see that we get CR mark over 2, BR mark over 2, AR mark over 2, mark over an indefinite number of subdivisions. And that's that proved. Theorem 11 shows that the scope of C8 can be extended. Now, if you remember, this was the proof of C8. You can see where C1 has been applied. You can see where J2 has been applied, hopefully. You move the R term out. And do you remember C7? We needed to transpose the A term to the outside and use the A mark B mark over 2, C mark over 2, and use that theorem to get the end result. Well, obviously, using C1, you can extend this as well. But it says use T10 instead of J2. You just apply what's been used in Theorem 10. Same with C9. And as you can see, we're taking the longer expressions and extended them even further. As long as the form is the same, then the same transformations can apply. This was what consequence 9 looked like. And the same thing applies, same kind of system applies. Now, theorem 13 extends C2. And it says that the generative process in C2 can be extended to any space not shallower than that in which the generated variable first appears. That means it can go deeper, but not shallower. Let's see how this works. This is C2. Remember, it's generating the term to the shallower space. And we extend it. So we want to move the G term on the outside to a deeper space and see how deep it can go. Again, let's work methodically. We can duplicate it in the space it's in, that's C5. We can duplicate it in the next space down, by C2. And we can duplicate it again by C2 from there, and we can take it away by C2 from any space where it has a duplicate term to the right. And that can go on indefinitely. So it can be copied in to all the levels or just one or two of them, as you like. Theorem 14 brings out an important point with respect to the constant. What does he mean by the constant? It's actually called reduction. There are two constants in the calculus, a Markov operator and a blank or void. This is important. It's not just the mark, which you see and work with, it's also the unmarked state, the mark over mark. These are both constants. From any given expression, an equivalence expression not more than two crosses deep can be derived. We'll come back to this when we look at content, image and reflection in chapter 8, but this is an important point. We also come back to the point that expressions will always be reducible to one of two simple forms, either marked or unmarked, and the unmarked state cancels and is equivalent to the space in which an expression appears. Now, let's look at a variable. We're going to take an expression with three levels, 0, 1, and 2. The lowercase letters, apart from V, stand for arrangements, and the V stands for a variable. What Spencer Brown is saying is that we need to prove that from any given expression, an equivalent expression can be derived that contains not more than two appearances of any given variable. So here, we're looking for no more than two V's. We start with the expression that has four V's in it. We take the first part of the expression and we put C1 over the V term, C1 over the B term, that creates a division of 2 within a space. And you can see that we can move the Q2 levels back by J2. You can cancel out the nested marks by C1, and the first part of the expression is equivalent to this. We do the same with the second part of the expression, and we copy the rest down. Now you'll see some of the bits have V's in them, some don't. We're going to extract all the ones that don't have V's in them, and he arranges them in alphabetical order from the deepest level up, and then we're going to name them G. So the expression E then becomes this. Taking this, we're going to use C1, J2, C1 to reduce the appearances of V's. Here's how it works. C1, create two divisions. We'll take the we'll take the V's out, J2, and that will produce an expression that looks like this. You only ever need two levels or two appearances, and you'll note that one of these has a single mark over it, another has mark over it. And those are the two basic states any term can be in. And that will apply to logic, as we'll see later on. But the next session, we'll be looking at Canons 7 and 8 and Theorem 16 in Chapter 8. Hope you can join me.